Good morning, children. Today in this class, we will discuss about agriculture. So we have been discussing last two classes about the topic agriculture. We have discussed about what is agriculture, and we have discussed about various methods of agriculture, that is primitive subsistence farming, primitive intensive farming, commercial farming. Apart from these three methods, shifting cultivation and plantation agriculture are small. So totally these are the five methods. In case they ask you short answers, we are able to write. Shifting agriculture. Agriculture will be done in a particular place. Once you lose soil fertility, after 2-3 years, people keep on shifting the place and cultivate the crops. This method of agriculture is called as shifting agriculture, or you can say jimmying, or you can say slash and burn agriculture. People use this as a slash and burn agriculture. You can call it the jimmying method or shifting method. Of course, this method in India, they are calling it different names. Not only in India, in the worldwide also, the shifting cultivation, I mean it is a jimmying, this will be used called as with the different names. Clear? Then coming to what is plantation agriculture. Plantation agriculture is agriculture which will be cultivated in a large area with a single plantation by using the high technology. By using the high technology and hybrid variety of seeds and producing more food grains. That is what is called as a plantation agriculture. They may ask you, give a few examples of plantation crops. Dash and dash are the best example for plantation crops. When you take a plantation crops, tea and coffee are the best example for plantation crops. Tea and coffee are the best examples for plantation crops. Apart from that, if you want to write, you can write down tea, coffee, sugarcane, rubber, banana and cocoa. These are all the plantation crops. Tea and coffee, then sugarcane, rubber. Rubber and sugarcane, cocoa, also important plantation crop, even banana. Give few examples of plantation crops. Children, tea, coffee, sugarcane, rubber, cocoa, banana. Yes. You know all the best example for plantation crops. Is it clear? But this, especially if you take a tea and coffee, we call it as a beverage crops. You know, the drinking, only for the sake of drinking we use cultivate tea, coffee. People are very fond of taking tea and coffee. These crops can be called as a technically beverage crops. Name two important beverage crops in the country. Name two important beverage crops of country, that is tea and coffee. And mention is climatic conditions. If you want to cultivate these crops, we need certain factors. We need certain favorable conditions. Especially these two crops requires very high temperature and heavy rainfall and fertile soil. These crops mainly grown in the hilly region, Darjeeling, even Assam, northeastern part of India. Assam and Meghalaya is the most important places to cultivate this tea. If you take a southern region, Baba Budan Hills, Nilgiri Hills of Tamil Nadu and Karnataka, Badans. These places are well known. Baba Budan Hills, Nilgiri Hills, famous for tea cultivation. So, tea and coffee. Coffee is Karnataka. Coffee more will be cultivated in the along the western borders in Karnataka. Karnataka is the leading state of production of coffee in the country. So these two crops, tea and coffee, is considered as a beverage crops. Name two important beverage crops in India. What climatic conditions require? Children, is very important for your examinations. So two beverage crops are tea and coffee, are considered as a beverage crops. What climatic conditions require? These crops requires, number one is temperature must be very very high, rainfall also very high, and soil will be fertile soil. Normally these crops will be cultivated across the country, northeastern region of Assam and Meghalaya, and southern region of Baba Budan Hills and western parts of Karnataka and the Blue Mountains of Tamil Nadu along the slopes of Nilgiri Hills. These are the areas where tea and coffee will be cultivated. Clear, children, this question? Now you know what are beverage crops, what climatic conditions require for beverage crops. Now coming to the fiber crops. Fiber, F-I-B-R-E. Name two important fiber crops and write its benefits, uses. I mean to say the merits. What are the merits of these fiber crops? Tell me, children, which are the important fiber crops? Yes, last one. Yeah, cotton and jute. Very good. Cotton and jute can be considered as fiber crops. Cotton, jute, and there will be two more questions, crops made here. That is, one is silk and hemp. One is cotton, jute, silk, and hemp. H-E-M-P, hemp. These are the four crops can be considered as fiber crops. Fiber crops. Especially if you take this cotton and jute, can be considered as fiber crops. When you take about cotton, cotton will be grown very high. Large parts of Maharashtra. Most of the cotton mills lies in the Maharashtra state. You know? Why, children? Why most of the cotton textile mills located in Maharashtra? Yeah. The state has, the area having certain favorable conditions like climate, skilled labor, water, raw material, cheap transportation, black soil. These are the favorable conditions available, convenient. All these favorable conditions are available in the state of Maharashtra. So therefore, maximum mills located in Maharashtra, cotton mills. In the case of jute, if you take, most of the jute mills lies in the Hooghly Basin, that is West Bengal. Why? Because of the same factors. What all factors we found in Maharashtra? The same factors are available, so convenient. The most available in that belt, Hooghly Basin belt, that is West Bengal. Therefore, the jute mills established in West Bengal. Most of the jute mills established in West Bengal. Reason is moist climate, black soil, cheap transport, banking facilities, network of harbor facilities, port facilities. I mean to say, port facilities and cheap labor. The most important factor is cheap labor. That's why most of the jute mills lies in the around the Hooghly Basin. You ask a question, my dear children. Why most of the cotton textile mills located in Maharashtra? Due reasons. Why most of the jute mills established around the Hooghly Basin? Due reasons. Explain. It's the factor. Children, are clear? Factors are both are same, but only thing is cheap labor, electricity, raw materials, black soil, banking facilities, insurance facilities, port facilities. Why port facilities required? After production, these raw materials have to transform to the different type of transportation, that is especially for navigation. Harbor, ports. These materials will be sent through the waterways by ships. Clear? So these two crops, cotton and jute, can be considered as a fiber crops. Upon that, silk. If you take silk, yes, Karnataka is the leading state. Karnataka is the leading production of silk in the country. Silk. So these three, four crops. So if they ask you, mention few examples of fiber crops: cotton, jute, silk, and hemp. You hear, children? Examples for the fiber crops: one is cotton, second one is jute, third one is silk, and fourth one is hemp. Fiber crops. Clear? Now we will come back to the most important crops regarding staple food crops. Yes. Which are the most important staple food crop of India? Mention its climatic conditions. Here there are two most important staple food crop of India. Number one is rice, number two is wheat. Number one is rice, number two is wheat. They are the two most important staple food crop of India. Because without consumption of these two crops, we cannot survive. We cannot live. How much you eat bakery items, how much you drink different kind of drinks. But the time comes, the food time comes, you have to take food, then only your stomach will be filled. Otherwise you feel unsatisfaction, unfilled stomach. So the most important staple food crop of India is, one is rice and wheat. Of course, southern states highly producing of rice, but the northern states give much priority for wheat. That is based on the climatic conditions. Based on the climatic conditions. Because we are in the heat zone, whereas in the northern direction, people living in the cold climatic zone. Now coming to the staple food crop, now you come to know, children, which are the most important staple food crop of India. Number one is rice, number two is wheat. Yes, these are the most important food crops of India. Now let us discuss about what are the climatic conditions required for these two crops. What are the climatic conditions required for these two crops? Number one is rice. Yes, rice is the most important staple food crop of India. Rice requires temperature must be 25 degrees. Children, rice requires temperature must be 25 degrees centigrade. Rainfall must be 100 to 150 centimeters per annum. Rainfall must be 100 to 150 centimeters and soil is alluvial soil. The three favorable conditions suitable for cultivation of rice. Temperature must be 25 degrees centigrade. Rainfall must be 100 to 150 centimeters, even 200 also chalega. And soil will be alluvial soil. And rice growing states in the country. Yes. In India, particularly today, which are the crop states highly growing rice in the country? West Bengal, Assam, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Orissa, Karnataka, etc. But rice generally cultivates every crop. But maximum production comes from Assam, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, and Karnataka. Kerala also. And even recently, even they start cultivating even Punjab as well as Haryana. Now the highly rice growing states in the country are Assam, West Bengal, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Karnataka, etc. You write 3-4 states. Major states. Because maximum production comes from those states. Maximum, the crop comes from those states. Clear? One is Assam, West Bengal, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. Most important question is this. Which is the most staple food crop of India? Rice is climatic conditions and mention which are the leading producing rice in the country. So staple food crop of is what is I told you already, that is rice. Clear? Climatic conditions, temperature must be 25 degrees centigrade, rainfall must be 100 to 150 centimeters, and soil is alluvial soil. And it's mainly grown in the complete coastal belt because it requires more water facilities. It requires more abundant of water. It requires plenty of water. Rice requires plenty of water, abundant of water. It should be sufficient, especially in the growth. During growth time, so always water should be stored. So temperature must be 25 degrees centigrade. Rainfall be 100 to 150 centimeters and alluvial soil. It mainly grown in the delta regions. You can say on delta regions like Assam, West Bengal, Orissa, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Karnataka. Is it clear, children? So this is all the questions which if you are concentrate more, easily you can write the exam. So therefore, once again I am telling you children, please be alert. So this class what we are discussing is agriculture, methods and different type of crops. Fiber crops we have discussed, plantation crops we have discussed and staple food crops we have been discussing. And we will continue with these crops next class also. Now prepare for your monthly test, periodic test. Already I have given the syllabus for periodic test, agriculture, manufacturing industries and lifelines of Indian economy. Is it clear? Prepare. All the best.